Okay, Katie, I'm going to give you a little rundown on how to install ImageJ. And so I'm just going to start from scratch. So we're going to go straight to Google. ImageJ, click there, go to download, Windows bundle. I'm going to get it with the 7, with the Java included. I'm going to put this in the downloads directory. Where is that? Downloads right here, and hit save. It says the zip can't be downloaded securely. Don't know why that says that, but I'm going to say keep so we can download it. And then I'm going to right click that and say show in folder. So it shows me where it is. And then in Windows up here, you should see this little extract when you select a zip file. So when you select that zip file, it should say extract. So you click that ribbon and extract all. And when you extract all, it will extract it all. And then you'll get a folder that has that same name. So I've already done this. You will get this folder that has the same name. Then you go into that folder and you'll see ImageJ, an ImageJ folder, go into that one, and then you have the program. And so you just run this program, double click it, and it'll work. Okay, so if we double click that, we hit run. Hello. Okay, there it is. It's this little tiny thing. It's like a, this is the program. It's small. Okay. And so what we have, what we analyze in our lab are these little black and white images, which I actually have right here. Let's see, where did I have that? Yeah, these little guys right here. And so, you know, we're looking at, you can drag this image up onto the toolbar, and when you let go, then it'll open that image. So that's a nice way to open the images. And this is our data. And so what we do is we draw a little square here. This is our control. This is clean. And we come up to analyze histogram. And this gives us an analysis of the dark pixels. And you see 255 would be perfectly white. 0 would be perfectly dark. So this would be called dirty. This would be called clean. And here's the mean value that you want to save. So this, now for us, we're just dealing in black and white, but if you wanted to do RGB, then you could click this once, twice, the third time you get the red channel. And so the red channel is, this is the mean value 0 to 255 for red. So this is how red that is, green and blue. So those are the RGB values for this particular box. And it's the average or mean, and here's the standard deviation. So that's kind of cool that you get statistics on your different colors. So you'll get RGB and you'll have plus or minus RGB. So you can look to see how much more red the sunset was than the looking up in the sky and seeing the blue light. So this would be a great way to quantify the color. So we were using the Analyze Histogram tool in ImageJ. And there's a lot of documentation associated with that, but I think that's overkill for your project. But still, the quantified color is not overkill, especially if you can just download this program and run it. So that's all you got. Just put your images in here, draw your little box. The cool thing too is if you wanted to get your data quickly, you can go around here and go back to red. And then you can just drag the middle of that box around. Oh, you got to hit live first. If you hit live, then it's live. And you can see it's reacting to wherever that box is. Isn't that cool? So you can have a, you know, your image up and you can do the red. And then you can come over and do another part of the picture. And you can get your average values that way. Okay. So that's ImageJ. Pretty easy to use. Very powerful program. And hopefully you can get it to work for your project. All right, take care.